Well, here today, I'm talking to one of our customers, Nathalyn Hernandez from Handmade Cabinets. Hi, Nathalyn, how are you doing today?
Hi, very good, and you?
I'm good. So, one thing that's really interesting about this event is it allows us to connect with our customers and to get some of our customers to understand the story of our successful customers who have their own businesses to run. So, that's why Nathalyn is here with us today.
Thank
So
you.
let me start off and say, with respect to handmade cabinets, tell us a little bit about the company and how you ended up where you are. What was the journey that brought you to where you are today?
Thank you. Yes. Well, we are a husband and wife team duo. We started back in our country about 8 years ago doing our own cabinets, bathrooms, and closets. It was a way to save money. And after that, families and friends started seeing what we were doing, and they wanted us to do it as well in their houses. So that's how we started. Eventually, we needed to quit our full-time jobs to dedicate all our time to do the cabinets. And then we came to the US, and for maybe 2 years, we didn't do cabinets. We were, evaluating the market, the industry. There was a lot of things that we didn't know. Because they were just different than in our country. And essentially, we are a company that do frameless cabinetry, like European style, because that's what we knew. So when we came here, we started the business. People started asking about shakers and rice panels, and we didn't even know what they were talking about. So that's why we needed to learn the business and learn the market and the things that are different here. Normally, I'm in charge of the administrative part of the business, the sales, the design, and my husband is in charge of the production. Basically, we just ourselves and a couple of helpers that we have during the installation and production process.
Right. So when you say administrative, I think you're shortchanging it a little bit because you're the design creativity in the company, right?
Yes, but we do, since we are the owners and this is a very small company, we do everything ourselves. So I do design and sales and administration, bookkeeping, purchasing, social media.
Right.
Yeah,
And
it's a lot, but it's fun.
so what did you guys do previously before you started this business full time?
Well, we are originally accountants and business administrators. It's our background, me and my husband, his too.
Okay, so kitchen design and the creative aspect of that, I'm guessing, is a bit more fun than accounting.
It is. I still love math. And there
Yeah.
is a lot of math involved in cabinetry, especially in the custom one. That's how we started with the custom frameless cabinetry made all from scratch. There's a lot of math involved.
Right.
A lot of Excel sheets too.
So you came from, from not being in this industry to now having a successful business. What was your experience of software, of design software? I'm sure you tried some things and there was a kind of progression that led you to
Yes.
2020.
At the beginning, it was just a piece of paper and a pencil trying to draw. I don't have any background in drawing, and I'm not an architect or anything like that, neither is my husband. But however, he's very handy, and he always had tools, as a home owner, but
Yeah.
he still liked that part. So we started with one software that it wasn't the best. I don't think it delivered everything that we needed, but it was what we could get at the moment, and it worked for about 5 years that we used it. I knew it was obsolete, that it wasn't working anymore. But when you are reluctant to change because you are so used to something, and it's
Yes.
like it was my comfort zone. I didn't want to get out of there. But I knew that eventually needed to do it because just the renders weren't the best. I didn't have the capability to import like textures or real brands, like real appliances, I couldn't do any of that. And the renders, they were not showing the reality.
Right.
Like how I wanted the project to look at the end, what I wanted the client to see, those renders weren't doing it.
Right, I understand. So in the last couple of years, it's been a little bit crazy, right? So the pandemic came and everybody thought this industry was going to go into a decline, and then everything took off. So how has it been for you? What was that roller coaster like for you, including the very beginning? Did you also have a little bit of a downturn or what?
Well, we started with 2020 in year 2020, actually. It was actually December 26, 2019. So we started 2020 with 2020.
Right.
And yes. So I was like, this is cool. And I could immediately see the difference in the renders, and immediately were able to gain more clients by showing them a better product. And it also allowed us to get in contact with interior designers as well, because we were able to show them a product that was, you know, up to their standards. And then pandemic came and we thought that we were going to be downhill like everybody, but it was quite the opposite. And I think this business, the whole industry just picked up, because I even talked with other designers and they said that they, you know, they can be like keep up with the work because they have so much. And it was the same with us. It was a lot of clients. I'm still behind, you know, doing everything yourself. There are not enough hours in the day to do everything that I need to do.
Right. So, that's a good position to be in. And
it's a good problem to have.
Yes. And we hear that from all of our customers as well.
Yes.
In particular, you mentioned the renderings and things like that, but are there any other favorite things that you have that you see in the software that help you to be more productive, to move faster and to win the deal? Is there anything specific that you'd like to call out on?
Let me see. I recently changed to 2020 Design Live, and I can see that the renders are a lot faster, and I love that. The lightning, I used to invest a lot of time in lightning, because that's the deal. That's what makes things, you know, look beautiful. But with 2020 Design Live, lightning was like already there and it was so much easier and it saved so much time.
Right.
And I really like that option.
So you mentioned earlier on that a lot of what you do is more modern, frameless, and so on. I mean, I recently built a house, and my kitchen is entirely frameless. And I went for the, you know, no handles, no hardware approach.
Uh-huh. Push to open.
Push to open, push to close. And a lot of my friends really love it, but they would be too scared to do it themselves. Yes. They're conventional. So how do you see the market for more contemporary designs? Are you seeing that people are being more open to that?
I think so. We have been here about 5 years. The first 2 years, we didn't really do any of the cabinets as we were evaluating the business. Then we saw that our expertise wasn't necessarily what people were looking for. They were looking for more shakers, more transitional, traditional style. So we started set up with other, you know, cabinet companies that could provide us with those kind of cabinets. But still, we didn't put on the side our frameless style, because that, I think that's what made us different. There are a lot of cabinet companies here in this area that can do framed cabinets. It's just like what is more common, but how many companies can do frameless cabinets from scratch, like completely custom? Not that many. So that's what I think made us, you know, so popular, or start getting people's love.
Right.
And I think And I think that style is going more popular now. Especially, I've seen some TV shows that are using that cabinet style. Probably not in Florida or more conservative states, but like I would say Las Vegas, LA, they are more open to that style. Even Miami here in Florida, that's what they use over there more, you know, more popular. But here in Central Florida area where I am, it wasn't that trendy, and I think it's starting to become more popular.
Okay. So one aspect of this industry that's quite interesting to us and important to us is that there are a lot of new customers of 2020 that come on board every month, hundreds every month. And sometimes they're people who are chasing their dream. They've thought about wanting to do this for a long time. Sometimes they've come from a dealership where now they're ready to go out on their own. And sometimes they came from one of the, you know, the big stores, the big DIY stores, and they want to go on their own. Knowing what you know today, what would you, if I was asking you, what is the advice you would give me if for somebody who is thinking about starting up their own business in this industry?
I thought about it for a long time. We started as independent contractors. Like, we didn't actually create the company until 2019. So officially, we're just being in business 2 years, even though we have had a lot more experience with it. So at the beginning, we were thinking about, like, is there any niche in the market for us? Is there any fit in the market for us? But 2020 made it easier, because the amazing renders they put you in the, like, in the market. And when you already have some kind of experience, even with other design softwares, it's just easier to pick it up. Even though I was so reluctant to change, that I went to another city and took a 4-day training in person. And I think that made it easier, because even though 2020 is very user-friendly, it has some secrets and things that, you know, it's good when other people tell them to you. You all also can find out by yourself by doing, you know, watching tutorials or going to the 2020 website. There are a lot of forums. There is a big designer community out there that is willing to help. And every time that I've had questions or, you know, doubts about what I can do in 2020, I don't hesitate to ask, even to, you know, going to the 2020 team or going to another designer. And they're always willing to help, always. So I think that that's a good thing about this community. Everybody's willing to help, and I love that.
Right. You mentioned training, and for a long time now we've been focused on web-based training, but now we're starting to schedule in-person classes more. And in the past, my experience has been that people who attend really like to meet with other designers and so on. Did you have that kind of experience when you did your training?
Yes, and it was amazing. Because I was like in the middle. I wasn't a beginner because I already had experience with another software, but I wasn't like the person that had more experience in there. So I was able to help others that were like trying to go to this industry for the first time, that they weren't designers at all. So they needed to learn like everything from scratch, basically. Or I was also able to learn from other people that had been working with 2020 before, and they were working with the cabinet companies already. So it was quite an interesting experience. It was 4 days full of knowledge, I would say.
Great. Yeah. So with respect to where we are today, with everybody being busy and you being busier than you can even cope with, what are your plans? I mean, how are you? Do you want to expand the business? And if so, how are you going to do that?
It's hard, you know, because as I said at the beginning, it's my husband and me and just a couple of helpers. And we do everything ourselves because we love what we do. And sometimes we have seen other companies where the owners are not that involved. And then sometimes installers don't do the best job when they are doing it, when, you know, when they are, when they don't have their hearts with the company, when they just do it for a pay rate. So I think that most of our success is also happy customers at the end that spread the voice about you, that recommend us to other people, friends, families, because they like the job that we do. And that is because we do it with passion, and we do it because it's like, if it was for us, like for ourselves, like at the beginning, 8 years ago, like if we were doing our closets in our own apartment. So I think that's what set us apart. And I kind of like it to keep it that way, but I know that I only have 24 hours of the day. And so eventually I need to, you know, delegate a little bit or start training somebody. Because yeah, there is so much that I can do. And I don't really like to tell people that they need to wait a few weeks for a design. I really don't like that, but that's the point that we are right now, unfortunately.
So,
but yeah,
so
I think we need to start training more people.
Right. So this is interesting because one of the things that came into my mind was that you've had the experience of coming from a different background.
Yes.
And learning this. So would you think you might be interested in finding somebody that shows passion and good work ethic and loves customer satisfaction as much as you, but maybe doesn't come from the industry? Do you think you would be able to train that person up?
Yes, of course. I was trained. With the previous design software that I was doing, I was trained. Even though I didn't have any experience with it. But it also depends on how eager you are to learn. And I was very eager to learn. So, and I think that's a big difference. Sometimes, you know, it's the enthusiasm that you put into the things you're doing.
Right. So then you're not restricted then to having to go out and recruit an existing designer who... during what is a very, very tough market right now. So
yes,
you really just want somebody who's smart and young and full of energy and
correct,
ready to learn, right?
Yeah, everything is teachable. Everybody can learn.
Okay. So do you have any other ideas or feelings about where this industry is going in the future? Do you see trends that are happening with respect to kitchen design and colors and things like that? Or do you have something in your imagination that tells you that things might change a little bit?
Yes, as we talked before, I think we're going for more full access cabinetry, more modern look. And I honestly like it. That's the style that I like. I'm planning to start renovating my own home here. And that's the style that I want to give it. And I think in colors, I mean, people are not afraid of colors anymore, I don't think. I've seen kitchens that are a teal color. We did a green one. I did a navy blue one, and shiny navy blue in modern, like a modern look. Mm. So I think the industry is going over there. And I also think after the pandemic, the industry is going for more work from home, remotely kind of thing. So designers are going to be able to do a lot more from their houses as well.
Right. Yeah, that's an important aspect, because especially with the fact that remodeling and new construction is going even more flexible space oriented, right?
Yes.
So you want to be able to perhaps even work from your kitchen, which
yes,
I think is a fantastic thing. I do that all the time. And that kind of building that functionality in a way that doesn't intrude and looks cool.
Exactly.
Is a nice design challenge to have, I think.
Yes, Last week or 2 weeks ago, we finished a project that was a playroom slash office, home office. So it had two desks for the kids, and it also had an area for them to watch television, play video games, and it was also like a bookshelf. It had a little bit for, you know, a little bit of everything for that room, for that small space. And it was kind of cool. And it's not the first one that we have done. We have done several home offices in the last few months.
Okay, that's cool.
Yeah, and they are all custom made.
Right, right. So with that, I think we've covered everything that we want to cover today. So I just want to thank you for your time. Really appreciate it. I'm really glad that you're a 2020 customer, and hopefully you're as happy as you're making your customers.
Yes, of course. I will continue to be with 2020. Of course.
Great. Thank you very much, Nathalie.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you very much.
Bye.